Oh, foil Domri Red. How much is that worth? Interesting. So I'm definitely gonna take the foil Domri Red. although I am gonna look at the rest of the pack. As much as I want to pass it to put my opponents into the into Gruul. I'm kidding. This is a grisly spectacle that I'm passing, unfortunately, but I'm gonna take it before it goes away. How much is that worth? Jeez, that seems expensive. Foil Domri. Buying for 16. Buying for 19. What are they selling it for? Rubble Hulk. That's a card. It's really, really aggressive. I mean, man, there are some games where you can lose just, they have seven lands and they have that in the Double Striker or that in Boros Charm. This card's just really cool. And it's just huge. Look at it. Dimir Gilgate might. Nah, I can't take it. It might table. I'm gonna take Basilica Screecher instead. It's just a good extort card. Sometimes you get like three extort creatures in play, just take them for three, take them for three. And it's, of course, very good with Call the Nightwing. I don't want to forget that I have Obsidian in my deck. Man, that card. I hope these Devour Fleshes are going to be good. Alright, I have a bunch of pretty unplayable blue black cards. No white cards. I could take Frilled Oculus, but I'm just going to take the Gilgate instead. A 1/3 is nothing to sneeze at. Even though it's really cool when you pump it, like it's just a good card anyway. 1000 Lashes. Well, that deals with the creature. It does everything I want it to do. I have a lot of removal in this deck, so I better have a payoff here. I leech him dry, just leeching him. One point at a time. One point here, one point here, one point here, just leeching him. Oh, a 3/2 extort? Is that just another card with extort? Don't mind if I do. The Zurichi Tiger's not gonna get there at this rate. Oh, here's that 2/2 I was talking about. So the Khorshrik Denizen is interesting in that every turn I can tap something with like Obsidot, but I only have really if I have Obsidot in play, if I'm lucky enough to have it, that's good enough anyway. And I'm not really attacking so aggressively that I want to have a 3-mana 2/2 over a 2-mana 2/2. And I need this 2-mana 2/2. I need to have a creature that I can block with early. Really important. None of these cards are good. What is this? Sylvan Primordial? 6/8. What a weird creature type. Just a non-creature permanent? Alright, well, gotta be careful for that, I guess. Back in Apparition or Act of Treason seems like the card I'm gonna be worried about the most. I think what's more likely, however, is that I play a 1/4 in certain matchups. Like, this card's a really good, like, stick in the ground against certain matchups, and there's sometimes where I'm gonna want that, so I'm gonna take it. Even though I'm splashing it, I'm still gonna take it. Death's Approach, I can't take still. I'm not milling them almost at all, so I can't. Really, this won't is not real, it's not a reliable form of removal. I have Devour Flashes. I have other ways to kill creatures. It's just not reliable. And I already have enough removal anyway that I don't need it. So I'd rather just play this 2/2. This 2/2, I really need it.
Sorry.
So none of these cards are playable. Mind Grind. What I reveals cards until I reveal X land cards and then put all them into the graveyard. So. If they have 10 lands in their deck and I do it for 12, they're dead. Well, maybe I do it later. This card seems like it's pretty bad. I don't really want to play this Khorshrik Denizen. I can't imagine playing it, to be honest. So I'm going to take this Mind Grind. Maybe it's a good board card. But I don't really like it that much. Oh, yes. The Dimir Gilgate table. That's game. Man, that's nice. None of these cards are all that great. There's Bioshift is. Certainly not unplayable. Sometimes I've done something like Act of Treason my opponent's creature, bio shift all the counters off, and it feels real nice. But I'm not going to really get all too excited about that just yet. I'd rather play a card like, oh, I don't know, Last Thoughts. I don't think I'm going to play that either. I'll play none of these cards. None of these, I mean, this end of the pack, I'm just talking to talk at this point, but just taking whatever I can get my hands on. Where the, I have three Guild Gates, so at least that turns itself on if I need an effect like that. This +2/+2 unblockable Way of the Thief. if there's a this is a deck where I feel like they're low on removal and I need to be aggressive, that'll let me do it. So here we go. I'm just putting in all the cards I know that I'm pretty happy to play. Smog Elemental is interesting. It's 6 mana for a 3/3 flyer. Not the best deal in the world. Looks like it has googly eyes, kind of. Mortis Strider is interesting. I can basically extort endlessly with it. I didn't quite realize that. So I can attack, and if they block, I can extort. Well, we'll see if that's where I want to be. Definitely interesting. Do I gain a life off this, or is it just lose a life? Oh, just lose. 1,000 lashes. Dummy Red, can't play it, unfortunate. Call the Nightwing, I'm definitely happy about being able to play. I have a bunch of things to splash it now. Leyland Phantom, I'm less excited about, but I do have Extort, so we'll see how it goes. Assault Griffin, I'm actually not very much white at all, except just the first picks. But I definitely want to get up to like 20. Two cards, maybe 23 for 18 or 17 lands. Mind Grain doesn't really feel playable to me. If he has 20 cards in their library, I mean, it's less about the size of the library and more about how many lands they've drawn. If they've drawn 6 or 7 lands in the game, it's like I just can't mill them. It's just not possible. I can mill all up to 8 lands. They'll have like 7 cards left and they can't do it. But I'll definitely think about boarding it in. Smog Elemental, you're in. Horror of the what? The Dim? You're probably in. Zuriichi Tiger, you seem like you're in. This Nav Squad Commander, you seem like you're in. They're expensive cards, though. Mortis Strider is a card I'm going to consider later. This Leyland Phantom, I'm not sure how good it is, but I like that I can just extort with it. I've said that a few times already, but I just like it, man. All right, I like it like this. I like playing 18 lands. I have the mana, things to do with my mana. And I have expensive stuff to boot. So let's get my mana in order. I have all black sources on my duels. That's always the way it is. Let's go up to 10 black sources to start. For blue sources, I'm going to go up to 4 total for now. And for white sources, I'm going to go up to 6 total for now. Make that 7 or 8 total for now. Where are we at? That seems perfect. Okay, so I have 4 blue sources and 2 blue cards. That seems fine. I have 10 white sources and these white cards. That seems like almost too much, but maybe that's fine. And then I have 10 black sources. I should actually cut a plains for a swamp because I have Orzhov Signet. Then I'll have 12 black sources, in which case maybe I should play an island. So now I have 9 white. I have 10 white sources with the key rune, 11 black sources with the key rune, and then I have 5 blue sources. And the blue sources will help me cast Deathcult Rogue. So not all is lost. And if I play this many blue sources, maybe I can play something like the Clinging Anemone to be able to defend better. Maybe that's not a good idea, though. Is it better than Horror of the Dim? Probably not. Having a 2/5 or even a 3/6 defender blocker, huge game. These Gutter Skulks are going to be pretty underwhelming, but I have to do something on turn two. Just gotta get out there and do something. Leyline Phantom. What do I do about that? I like it as is. I don't see a way to change. I see a reason to change this. I might want to play Mortis Strider to be able to have a long-term plan to kill them with Undercity Informer, and a long-term plan to be able to extort with it, and like just because it's gonna be hard for them to get through. So what would I cut for that? I don't want to cut a Gutter Skulk for it, although I could. Corpse Blockade is another reason to play Mortis Strider because I have 2 infinite blockers now. I think the card to cut would be Horror of the Dim. Nav Squad Commander at least is like a 4/6 attacker in the late game. And it's a better blocker. This card doesn't seem like it's gonna really cut the mustard. I don't think it likes mustard. So yeah, I'm gonna do it like this. Okay, perfect. So 18 lands, I got lower curve, the Mortis Trader's in. I feel like I kind of want to play the Psychic Strike after Gore, so we'll see how that goes.